Just talking about so you creating the instrumentals and the beats, and then Nito goes in and mixes and records everything.
Yeah.
And so when he does that, like, what do you guys, like, with you coming in today, like, what is the, like, what is the kind of conversations you normally have? Like, do you, like, tweak stuff while you're with him?
Yeah, or? Pretty much. It's yeah. Just having extra ears.
Yeah.
Even if it's not our track, we try to add our two cents. Maybe yeah. We want it to sound cohesive. Like,
yeah.
Everything sounds like it's melded together and we're just one person.
Yeah.
So we try to add our input and you know, see where we can make changes.
Yeah.
Riz has got most of his friends coming in, playing live instruments and stuff.
Yeah.
So like even on a track like Cool Chick, it was his friend that came in and just played live piano.
Yeah.
Pretty much made it in the studio.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cool.
I know, and so as far as like creating instrumentals, you know, what is that process like? Like how do you make it? Like how do you know? like do you have obviously like a background and you know?
Sometimes it just you just start playing around with it and you don't know where it's gonna go.
Mm-hmm.
Like a track like Levitate was pretty weird because like what I did was I took a acapella and I broke it down so it was just a couple words and then I structured it so you could play chords with the words.
Yeah.
So it would play a musical sound but it was actually words. So that's how I broke it down. I think that's why it makes it sound so different. Because it's not an actual instrument but it's a voice.
Yeah, right? it's a voice.
So actually when Riz rapped on it, I was a little worried that it would be too much of a contrast.
No.
But it just worked out perfectly.
So. Yeah. Like it comes in right at like the perfect time.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, that was I think that's by far probably my favorite of everything we've heard so far today. Levitate. Yeah.
And it's actually pretty cool because like Riz got at me at a time where I didn't want to make stuff for rappers. So I joined this group and it was a lot of EDM producers. And they kind of just like, we would do beat battles every Wednesday.
Here in Edmonton?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was called Let Us Produce Beats. And it was just like maybe six or seven of us.
Okay.
But it really challenged me to like make stuff because I didn't really do EDM, right? So for me to like, you know, catch up to what they were doing, I had to really learn it quick. But I had to do something different to kind of stand out, right?
Yeah.
So that's one of the beats that came out of that. Because I just wanted to make something really different.
Yeah.
And you want to showcase it to these other people.
Absolutely.
So you try to make it big.
Yeah.
And that's how that record turned out.
It's such a big track. Yeah.
And like he said, that song sets the standard. So I can't make anything that's worse than that, right? So it has to be better.
So how much, how much percentage are you putting into this project? I know he's working with other producers as well.
I don't think there's like a percentage wise, I think whatever you're feeding him, he just keeps writing.